Hello everyone, I'm Brandon with Lenovo and I'm here today with the M93p small form factor desktop. Today we are going to be replacing the microprocessor and heatsink fan assembly. This process will take about 30 minutes and you may want to have a little experience working with computers before attempting this. The only tool required will be a Phillips screwdriver. Before we continue, we need to make sure that we're protected against electrostatic discharge or ESD. Make sure to shut down your computer and disconnect all cables and accessories from the system. For more information, watch our Understanding Electrostatic Discharge video by clicking the link in the description. And now that we're ready, let's get started. To remove the computer cover, we must remove two thumb screws in the back of the machine. The first thumb screw and the second thumb screw. Then we're going to press down on the release button and slide the cover towards the rear of the chassis and remove it. And now we're going to remove the heatsink fan duct, which is done by pulling these two latches apart and lifting the fan duct out of the system. Now we're going to disconnect the fan cable from the system board. Now we're going to loosen four capture screws in a cross pattern. Loosen the first screw halfway and loosen the second screw fully. Now loosen the first screw fully. And loosen the third screw halfway. Then loosen the fourth screw fully. Finally, loosen the third screw fully. Now we're going to remove the heatsink fan assembly from the chassis. To release the processor door, we're going to press down and outward on the latch and open the door fully. Then we're going to grasp the processor along the outside edges and lift it from the socket. And here we have our new processor. When replacing the microprocessor, it is important to make sure that the triangle in the corner of the microprocessor is aligned with the marking on the system board. Once you have those two lined up, you can just place the processor into the socket. Now we're going to close the CPU door and press down and inward on the latch to secure it. If you're not replacing the heatsink, then you need to clean the excess thermal compound off of it. To do this, I have some isopropyl alcohol swabs. Just going to hold the heatsink and gently, in a circular motion, wipe the excess thermal compound off of it. Allow the excess alcohol a few minutes to evaporate. So now we're going to reapply the thermal compound. You just want to put a pea-sized dab in the middle of the processor. If you've received a new heatsink fan assembly, then the thermal compound will come pre-applied and you can skip this step. Now we're going to place the heatsink fan assembly onto the system board using the screw holes for alignment. And tighten four capture screws in a cross pattern. Tighten the first screw halfway. Tighten the second screw fully. Then tighten the first screw fully. Tighten the third screw halfway. Then tighten the fourth screw fully. Now tighten the third screw fully. Tightening the screws this way allows the thermal compound to spread evenly underneath the heatsink. Now we're going to connect the fan cable to the system board. To replace the heatsink fan duct, align it with the fan and then drop it down until the two latches on the sides click into place. When replacing the computer cover, we want to assure that we're lining up the tabs on the cover with the slots in the chassis. Just kind of place the cover down onto the chassis and slide it forward. Finally, we replace two thumb screws in the rear of the machine. The first thumb screw and the second thumb screw.